This is like a speaker system that was built into a headboard for a bed. And removed it and added a Bluetooth receiver to it. So my phone's transmitting to that. That just goes into the line in here. And then when you put these speakers in a wooden enclosure, they sound pretty good. So it really puts out, the idea is to put this in a box with a battery, and it's a portable Bluetooth boombox.
The basic concept is a battery connected to a voltage adapter for the amplifier and speakers, as well as another adapter for two USB ports. While one port is left open to charge external devices, the other powers a Bluetooth to inline adapter, which receives music from a paired device and sends it through a stereo headphones jack to the line-in jack on the amplifier. I can tell now that containing all this in a neat little box will require some modifications. Cutting one end off the cable reveals three wires that are individually insulated. I find several pictures online showing what channel each ring on the end of an audio cable carries. Knowing this, I can use the continuity setting of my multimeter to find that yellow is ground, red is the left channel, and blue is the right. I can plug the cut cable into the line-in jack on the amp, and again use the continuity setting to find that this pin is ground, this one is left, and these two are right. With this inside, I remove the metal face on the amp so I can solder each individual wire to their appropriate pin. I apply a generous amount of solder flux to both ends of the wires and to the pins. I then carefully solder them into place, one by one, and after checking that it works, I add some hot glue to hold the wires in place. Now the audio cable is connected directly to the amp's PCB. It doesn't stick out to get damaged or broken. It even leaves the jack open to accept another cable, should I want to connect a device that doesn't have Bluetooth. My next issue is supplying power to this barrel jack on the amp. My solution is to first determine what pins correspond to the positive and negative terminals, then remove the power jack from the amp. Next, I solder the output wires from my voltage adapter directly into the amp's PCB. Now there are no wires that need to stick out of the box and only one power jack. I've noticed that the Bluetooth adapter will make the speaker buzz a little bit while it's powered on. It also hinders audio performance when I try to play something through an actual cable. I decided to add a switch that will cut power to the USB ports. This proves to solve the problem, as well as another where the Bluetooth adapter would always be powered on. I installed another switch that both the amp and the Bluetooth adapter get power from, but now I have three switches controlling two things, so this red switch on the amp isn't necessary anymore. So I took the easy route by removing the red cap and snipping it short so that when it's turned on, it stays underneath the faceplate. I cut out a wider faceplate to accommodate the recent changes and center the old faceplate on top of it and trace the holes, omitting the ones for the red switch and power jack. I've drilled a hole for the charging jack off to one end and marked out where to put the two switches on the spare USB. I drill several holes inside each rectangle and file them out to make rectangular holes. I use the old faceplate to mark the screw holes on each side of the new plate and drill those out. I then use a larger bit to countersink each screw hole so the screws will mount flush. I can now mount everything to my faceplate. I make sure a cable can still plug into the USB port as I tighten the screws. I attach the charger port and amp, and then hot glue the voltage and USB adapters on each side. Next, I crimp a spade connector to the positive wire on the USB adapter and slide it over a terminal on the switch next to it. This will be my Bluetooth toggle switch. I then snip off some excess red wire from my charger port and twist one end of it into the positive input wire for my voltage adapter. I crimped a spade connector onto this wire and slide it over a terminal on the other switch. I cut the remaining wire short and use it to connect the two switches together. I want an LED light to light up whenever the Bluetooth switch is turned on, so I solder a 470 ohm resistor to the negative lead of this blue LED. I solder wire leads to it and find out that using a lighter to heat shrink the connections ruins the LED, so I try again using a green one. This time I use my soldering iron to only shrink wrap the negative lead. I coat the rest with hot glue, but leave the resistor uncovered so it can stay cool. I drill a hole right below the Bluetooth switch, insert the LED, secure it with hot glue, and wire it to the Bluetooth switch. I decided to get an inline noise reducer to help with some of the noise that the Bluetooth receiver makes. As it turns out, the jacks for the power and line out are so close together that I can't plug cables into both of them. Luckily, I can remove these jacks and solder the appropriate wires in their place, solving this design flaw and saving space all at the same time. So now the audio cable is soldered at each end to both the noise reducer and the amp's PCB, and the positive wire ties into it so it turns on and off with the Bluetooth receiver. For several reasons, I made my own lithium-ion battery. I salvaged these 18650 cells from a dead laptop and ordered this PCM and battery cradle online. I used part of the old faceplate as a mounting bracket for the battery, as I planned to just screw it to the inside of the box. I also used pieces of plastic as spacers between the PCM and cradle, and even made this plastic button that can be pressed to show the battery's remaining life. I even recycled the barrel jack I removed from the amp and soldered the battery's leads to it. It's finally time to make the box. I cut two pieces of 3/4 inch pine for the front and back pieces, and four more to make it the top, bottom, and sides. I use a router to cut rabbit joints into the ends of the top and bottom pieces, and all sides of the front and back pieces. I then used my table saw to cut two dados 6 inches into these same pieces. These hold some wooden slats that divide the box into three compartments. I set my battery inside and mark a rectangular hole around the top end, which I then cut out. I then drill some very carefully marked holes into another piece of aluminum. I then hot glue tiny squares of plexiglass on the underside of the aluminum over the smaller holes. I carefully line the holes up above the LEDs and hot glue the faceplate on. I didn't show it, but I glued more spacers onto the PCM so that the faceplate rests above it and doesn't short anything out. I center the battery in my box and trace around the face, then clamp some pieces of wood to the sides of the router table, making sure they're squared with the fence. I set everything up so the dado bit can only cut as deep as the faceplate is thick, and only within the traced outline I marked earlier. The result is a nice indentation the battery's faceplate rests in. I repeat the process for the amp, literally putting it front and center. I then use a compass to draw 2 4-inch circles from the speakers, which luckily don't need to be perfect. Next, I cut notches in the dividing walls for wires to go through, drilled breather holes behind each speaker, as well as 2 5/16 holes between the battery panel and front. I then apply glue to each joint and clamp it together. I don't glue the front on just yet, but still clamp it in to make sure it fits later on. I drill a 3/4-inch hole inside the center of the bottom piece, but only about a third of the way through, and drill the rest of the way from the other side with a 5/16 bit. I then glue the face on, sand it, stain it, and apply clear coat. I install metal mesh with thin film on the inside of the breather holes, as well as 1/4-inch T-nuts in the two holes on top, and in the hole on the bottom. I tighten bolts into the ones on top and leave the bottom as is. I glue the Bluetooth receiver in, connect all components, screw them into place, and put felt feet on the bottom. It's finally finished and I can already see it being useful for a variety of things. The two bolts on top accept the selfie stick tripod mount I made, which can hold my device while watching a movie or just be used as a dock. I can mount a tripod on the bottom to make the boombox a freestanding wireless loudspeaker, or carry it on my shoulder for a retrofill, then use it to win back the love of my life. I'm impressed with how well it sounds and breathes, and with all things considered, I think it turned out pretty well.
So thank you for watching. Feel free to like, subscribe, or comment, and I'll see you next time.
This tape is a pain in the butt. Well, that's useless. Careful. We'll connect all the negatives together. Yeah, that's still hot.